Leviton offers a variety of QuickPort and 110 style patch panels in both flat and angled versions. In this video, we'll demonstrate how to terminate an angled patch panel and share some tips to do so successfully. For this termination, we'll be using a data wire strip tool, a 110 punchdown tool, and a pair of flush cutters. An important thing to note is that when terminating the angled 110 style patch panel, the cable running down the left-hand side of the rack will terminate on the right side of the panel. As an overview, we'll start on the bottom module, terminating the inboard bottom section of the IDCs, followed by the inboard upper section. Follow this zigzag pattern until all the cables fan outwards and lay nicely over the inner cables. To begin, bring the cable in to estimate the necessary length and cut the cable to length. With a data strip tool, go around the cable once to remove the jacket and expose the wiring inside. With flush cutters, remove any non-pair elements. This may be a strip string, a more traditional cross separator, or Mylar tape. In this case, a strip string and cross separator are being removed. An important reminder, especially in low light conditions, is to inspect the wires after cutting to ensure that none of the pairs were cut or damaged in the prep process. Once the cable is prepped, route the cable over to the IDC. A common mistake is to come into the IDCs from the side, but doing so leaves the blue pair short and the brown pair long. A better approach is to come in from the center and splay the pairs out to where they are needed, as indicated by the colored marking on the IDC. This way, all the pairs end up being an appropriate similar length. Leviton's patch panels include pair separation towers, which can be used to help split the pairs. Use the colors marked on the IDC, which align with the colors of the pairs, as a guide when splitting the pairs. Once you have positioned the pair, punch it down using a punch tool set to the low impact setting and remove any wire remnant. Continue to lay in and punch down the other pairs and ensure they are all well seated before removing any wire remnants. Follow the same steps for the IDC just completed, but this time direct the wires upward. Continue this zigzag pattern until the lower right side of the inboard module is complete. Then complete the lower right side of the outer module. Once the lower right modules are complete, work on the lower left modules. To do this, bring the cables in from the right side of the rack and terminate the most inboard lower module first, followed by the outer lower module. Once all four lower modules are terminated, follow the same steps for the top modules, beginning with the right inboard module, then the right outer module, and finally the left inboard and outer modules. For more information, please visit www.leviton.com/copper.